Hi guys, I'm Sadie. Today we're playing some more Stories Untold. We're getting right into chapter 2. It's called The Lab Conduct. We played The House Abandoned last time, but if you missed it, I'll leave a link in the down there to a playlist where you can get all caught up. For now, let's jump right back in.
Ooh.
New session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, assisted by Dr. Williams, and in the lab itself, our volunteer, Mr. Asian. We have artifact 23 in the chamber, recovered from crash site B. At the moment, it appears inert, showing no signs of activity. Mr. Asian, instructions for each stage will come through to your terminal, and we need you to follow them exactly. Now, some of this may be unfamiliar, so always reference the manual on your terminal for guides on calibration and procedure. Once you've calibrated equipment to match our brief, the green light will flash, allowing you to trigger the experiment. One last thing. Ensure that any equipment non-essential to the current experiment is switched off. You cannot proceed until your calibration matches ours. When you're ready, let's bring this back.
Oh boy. Okay. This one's different. So we have experiment. Experiment 1, internal analysis. Subject J1986MEM is enclosed in solid outer layers. X-ray the artifact to determine its internal structure. Can we move over one? We don't really have mouse support. Oh, it says M. M for the manual. Electromagnetic spectrum, X-ray, acoustic resonance, safety instructions, concentrated light laser, drill press, and equipment layout. Let's look at the layout. Drill, X-ray, monitor, sink master, camera, test chamber, TV unit, signal generator, amp, and laser. Okay. Oh, this one's harder. The last one was just a text adventure. This one's very different. Let's see. So how do we run the X-ray? Camera, monitor set to X-ray, charge CC86 X-ray device. R3, RGB full color, IR infrared, XR X-ray. Oh boy. Okay. Well, let's see. Safety instructions are probably important. Use safety goggles and gloves at all times. Do not leave the container unattended during experimentation. It's extremely dangerous to handle any items within the container. Please ensure your next of kin is updated in HR. Oh my God. As per your agreement, follow all instructions exactly. Oh geez, okay. So, what do we do? Oh, tab turns us around. Okay. Well, there's the CC86. I don't think I can... Oh. Oh, I can use the mouse. I just turned that on and off. Oh, boy. Okay. Hang on, let's look back at this again. Required apparatus, the camera, the monitor, and charge CC86 X-ray device. Camera, monitor, and charge CC86. Okay, oop, no. Camera. Well, here's the monitor. And we want it on X-ray, probably. I'm gonna fail. That's the camera. And this is charging. Okay. What do I do now? Oh, I don't want that on. Awaiting X-ray data. Why is this one flashing? Sync master. What is this?
could work. The X-ray is coming through now. There's no visible damage to the surrounding organic material, and no signs of activity either. All output is flatlined. Okay, let's begin.
Okay, now what? Okay, experiment complete. Press enter to receive new experiment task. Demonstrate the effects of laser light on the object. Try using a low-powered red laser to begin with. Oh boy, okay. Laser. Red is 650 nms. Nanometers? I don't know what that means. Required apparatus. The laser light generator set wavelength and the monitor set to RGB. Okay. Okay, so this needs to be set to RGB. And then which one? Okay, the laser is on 650. Oh, that doesn't look good.
No reaction from first stage. Let's try high frequency.
Really? Okay. Demonstrate the effects of laser light. Use green laser. Oh man, we're hurting whatever this is. Green is 510. Okay. Well, let's reset this to 510. We're gonna hurt something. Looks like an alien heart. Oh, that's a terrible sound.
Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again.
Why are we doing this? This doesn't seem very nice. And that low buzzing is really, really annoying. Okay. Demonstrate the effects of blue laser. Oh man, isn't that the top? No, 455. Okay. Oh.
Would you look at that? It seems we have a pulse.
Ew.
Rhythm is stable. There's no activity registering in the core. It's possibly damaged.
Yeah, from hitting it with laser.
Push further.
Push further what? Test the acoustic resonance properties of the object. Begin with generating a 250 hertz sine wave with amplifier gain set to 1. Okay. 3. Signal generator set frequency and waveform, and amplifier set gain. Okay, so a sine wave, 250, 1 gain. Okay. Let's turn that off because it's like humming. I can turn the sound back up. Oh, geez. So it's this guy. We want sine wave. Oh. Really? Oh boy. You just drag it up. Okay. Let's do this. Which one's the gain thingy? Oh my goodness. This is silly. Okay, we want 250. Is this the gain thingy? Maybe it is. Oh no, this is right here. Okay. Almost there. 250. Come on, buddy. Oh, that's too much. Why won't it let me adjust? Okay. And then this we want. One gain? Oh, let's power it on. How do we know what gain it is? Oh. That's like 5 gain. Or 10 or whatever. Okay. Is that everything? Okay. Why are we doing this?
It's not much of a response. Updating the experiment now.
Okay. Increase the frequency to 500 sine wave and a gain of 5. Oh, this is so mean. What if it's... what if it's hurting him? You don't know. I wonder if there's a point to all of this, or are we just burning ants with a magnifying glass? Oh, that sound is getting higher and higher. Okay, come on. This is a little tedious. Oh, I wonder what would happen if I hit it with 501. It probably wouldn't let me because it does the light over here. Okay, so 5. Go.
Seeing some fluctuations in activity. Should we increase? Do the risk of damage? What about a long tier?
Ew. This
okay,
doctor guy.
Push further. I'm running out of time. Let's switch around.
This doctor guy creeps me out, dude. Switch to square sine wave. Square wave. Maintaining current frequency and gain. Okay. What is that gonna tell us? It's gonna blow up. Oh.
Seeing good activity on this side. Seeing definite spikes in movement.
Yeah, you're stressing it out.
Seem uncomfortable or dangerous. But you need to trust us.
Is this like my heart and I'm hooked up to like wires and stuff? Maintain gain 5 and square wave. Bring the waveform frequency up to 1,000? Oh my god. Oh, if you hold it, it'll climb. It's gonna blow up. He's getting too impatient and risky, this doctor guy. Oh. Oh.
Activity registering.
Full activity, it blew up.
You've made excellent progress. You're doing great. Now we need you to stay calm and try to relax as we go through these next steps. We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
What? Protective casing is off. Proceed to drill the surface? Oh my god. Switch the drill on. Ensure all other equipment except the camera and television are off. When ready, trigger sync master as normal to begin drill insertion. Okay, let's turn off everything. Off you. Off you. Off you. What is this? That's the sync master. What is this? Thing on. Is this thing on? No. Okay, the camera and the TV are on. I need to turn on the drill press. This is so awful. Why are we doing this? Oh, look, it's coming through on the thing. Oh! Oh my god.
you feel. Don't be scared. We have the situation under control. Take a few moments, and when you're ready, we'll continue.
What in the hell? Make contact with the artifact, open the test chamber? Are you crazy? I think Ginger thinks they're crazy too. She wants to play. She would have done things differently. She told me so. Okay, open the thing. I really don't want to do that. Oh my god. Oh, it's like Pod.
Ew. We're doing fine. Don't be afraid.
That's easy for you to say. This thing's gonna like blow
Sorry
up my brain. Ew.
I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this. It's time to remember.
It's time to remember what? Oh! Oh my goodness.
Don't try to speak. Stay calm.
Are you kidding me with this?
You're a proxy now. You have a connection to the entity's inner core.
Really?
It's like a conscious black box. It can show you its memories. Look into it.
I don't wanna.
Visions will translate onto the screen to be something that you can understand. That you can play out.
New data connection ready. Okay, what's the screen representation of that mess? You wake up in a cryopod, struggling against gravity. You force yourself up, impact into the planet's surface. Shut up, Doc.
You can navigate its memories. Use the computer. Work your way through.
Yeah, I got this. Jerk. Impact the planet's surface has torn a hole in the ship's hull. Poisonous atmosphere spills into your craft. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. I don't know. Look around. The craft is broken beyond repair. There's wreckage all around. An airlock door is locked tight, and the computer terminal adjacent blinks. Look, computer. The monitor blinks, demanding attention. The system looks usable. How about we spell correctly? You tap at the screen and the airlock door splutters to life, slowly opening with a horrendous noise. The ship powers down to silence, having spent the last of the reserves. Okay.
This organ was taken from what we think was the leader. These memories are different. They're not like the others. There's more detail here. Less hazy. Lean in. See what else it hides.
I'm gonna turn the sound down because that gets really obnoxious. Oh, man. More gross stuff. What the hell is that? Uh-oh. Great. You squeeze through the damaged airlock and fall to your knees on the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. You look around to see... Shut up, Doc.
Describing the moment we found the ship. Mr. Asian, please continue.
Mr. Asian? That's a weird name. Now you made me lose my place. You squeeze through the damaged airlock and you fall to your knees on the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. You look around to see you are surrounded by mangled metal. Bright lights pour through every gap in the surrounding wreckage. Oh no. A crash site. Smoke billows from the downed ship. Exterior lights flicker on and off. Wreckage surrounds you. Looking upwards, you see unfamiliar star patterns. Let's learn how to type. Wreckage surrounds you. Some of this metal will have to be moved in order to free yourself. Okay, move. Wreckage. With every ounce of your remaining strength, you move away enough of the wreckage for you to carefully crawl through. The lights that surround you now attack your senses. Oh, no, shield your damn eyes, stupid. Memory action unavailable, command not recognized. Fine. Look around again. We moved some stuff. A circle of artificial lights surround you, set up to illuminate the crash site in the darkness. Behind them, an army of people are all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks toward you. The silhouette is bipedal and bulky. Some sort of mask covers its face. It beckons you to approach. Okay, approach the person. Uh-oh.
Your heart rate is elevated, but you're doing well. For what it's worth, very few of our test subjects ever make it this far.
That's comforting.
You should be proud of yourself.
Why don't you eat my butthole? I somehow think I got swindled into doing this because it was like volunteer, quote unquote. This looks like a goddamn Nine Inch Nails video. Okay. Thank you for the mind meld. We awake? The room is silent only for the quiet hum of equipment and occasional machine beep. Your touch isn't yours. We are all as one. We are Borg. We will be assimilated. We move together in unison. We are in a bed, in a small and artificially lit room with a single door. There is some sort of writing pinned to the wall. Adjacent is a display monitor.
We didn't put this entity in quarantine. It expired at the crash. Whose memories are these? When
Doc,
did this happen?
You're an idiot. Just shut up and let me do my job. Adjacent is a display monitor with wires that drape across the room and into our chest. They have tortured us. Look at the writing. Stuck together are a series of flat sheets with symbols on them. It's some sort of writing. Read writing. Symbols seem to indicate where on our body they had to cut. We have been butchered and maimed over and over. Okay, look. Monitor? The screen didn't give anything away. Flashing symbols of what could be numbers in rhythm. Okay, that's a heart monitor. Wires drape across the room and into our chest. Artificially lit single door. Pull wires out.
There's been a disconnection in quarantine lab 15. Find out what's going on.
Ooh. We yank at the wires protruding from our chest. Together we all scream in pain. This action sets off an alarm echoing loudly down the adjacent corridor. The door in the corner looks atmospherically sealed shut. We'll open the mofo.
Stop. Specimen 20, left lab 15. It's on the move.
My God. That vision. It's not a memory. It's happening right now. Mr. Asian, I need you to stop what you're doing, please.
How about you suck my butt? You got me into this predicament. I'm gonna finish it. What's that? Oh. Oh my goodness. Who was that girl? Is that your girlfriend, homie? Through the door, we find ourselves in an empty room with a device on the table. It looks familiar. They don't know how it works, but this host does. The door closes behind us and a lock clamps shut. We are alone together. Some sort of preparation room. There are markings on more sheets, with a door and a window on one side. The door we came through has been locked shut. The other door had an orange alarm light above it. In the center of the room, a table holding only a small device taken from your It's My Hour ship. Is it a laser gun? Was an access code terminal for a wide connection allowing commanders to commandeer other hosts. Only you, I, we have access to these codes. It's time to use them. Okay.
What is that? You haven't seen that before. How is it doing?
It's using the tool we recovered from the crash site. It's in our systems. It's sending something across the network. It's broadcasting.
Mr. Asian, please. We deeply regret what we've put you through, but please understand it was for the greater good. We had to know more. Rebelling now could be catastrophic. You don't know what this might do to you in the long run.
I think they'll save me and they'll screw you. I think you finagled me in here. You finessed me and you're a big jerkbag. What do I need to do? Oh, I need to match up symbols? Okay. Well, they don't really have matches. Where is that symbol? I don't know. How about this one? Where's that symbol? Well, maybe it's that one. Where's that one? No, that's not right. How do I do this? Okay. Where is that one? I don't even see that one listed. Where's that one? I don't know. Select row, change glyph. Where is that symbol? I don't see that one on the screen. Well, maybe it's supposed to be... I don't know. Supposed to be some sort of access code. Okay, that one is probably the one I had it set on. Okay, this one isn't listed. Is it? Maybe it is. Hang on. I don't know. Where's that symbol? Do you have any idea how small this is on my screen? This is hard to do. Let me pause and see if I can get the right combo. Okay, I think I've got it. You can actually look into the eye of the creature and it gives you the clues. I just have to get this last one. I thought it was that. Oh, maybe it's... that? There. Oh, now what are we doing?
They're all free. They're converging. It's over.
Ooh, look at all those. Hey, now, I freed you guys. You'd be nice to me. And Mr. Dr. Man was a butthole. Did I just totally betray my species? Probably. Oh, jeez. One more mind meld? No.
Please, don't do this. We mean you. We mean death, no harm. Please, don't do something you'll regret. Wait.
Ooh.
One day, Mr. Asian, this will haunt you.
Oh, I was a bad boy. That was pretty good. Different. They had lots of extra things to do, not just the text adventure like the first one. Oh, jeez. And again, they made use of the sort of fiction vehicle of having what we're doing playing out in real time as well. If you remember in the first one, I had even said, oh, this is like when you're doing something and it's writing the book as you're doing it. You know, it's like one of those movies or one of those TV shows or whatever. And we were like sitting at the computer and it said, oh, he's coming up the stairs. And then all of a sudden the door behind us opened and they made use of that same vehicle, which is creepy as hell. That gives me just goosebumps like crazy. I don't really know what the entire message of the second story was, I guess. I mean, they had volunteer in quotes. That's the part that throws me. Not that obviously this was some sort of extraterrestrial entity, whatever, that they recovered from a crash site and whatever. But why was I volunteer in quotes? What was my, like, was I some sort of prisoner? Was I, you know, being blackmailed? And why was my name Mr. Asian? That's like AI Shun. Like, that's a weird name, right? Okay, maybe I'm just reading too much into it. That was good. That was creepy. It's definitely set the stage. So chapter 3 is called The Station Process. And we will jump right into that one the next time we play. I'll see you guys later. Bye.